The bigger picture for the work that we're doing is really about promoting visions of future life on another planet. And imagine, you know, what is a day in the life of an astronaut on Mars? Space exploration architecture is all about designing extraterrestrial habitats and envisioning future life on other planets. We're basically a collective of industrial designers, architects, technologists, researchers who come together to do work in the private aerospace industry that supports future human life on other planets. My name is Melody Ashar. I'm a co-founder and member of Space Exploration Architecture, that's SEARCH Plus for short, and I'm the team leader for SEARCH Plus and APIS Core's continued submissions to phase 3 of NASA's Centennial Challenge for 3D printed habitat. NASA's Centennial Challenge asks teams to not only design, but also create functional prototypes for future 3D printed habitats on Mars. We submitted to NASA's Phase 1 Centennial Challenge, won that competition in Phase 1 for a proposal called Mars Ice House, and have been sort of collaborating and working with private industry ever since. Mars Ice House is about using the properties of water to shield the astronauts from radiation in a superior way to aluminum or to Martian regolith, which is basically soil that you find natively on Mars. When we first started out, we were extremely intentional about the fact that we wanted to upturn a traditional idea of what it would mean to live in an extraterrestrial environment. Many people have a strong belief that the best way to protect astronauts from radiation would be to bury them underground and to live underground just for safety reasons and human health reasons. What we've been trying to do in our work, we wanted to be sure that the astronauts would not only live above ground, but would have plenty of access to natural light and have a connection to the environment that they've actually traveled so far to live in. Those were highly intentional factors in the way that we approached our work and the way that we approached our design, which ultimately, as a bottom line principle, introduced superior radiation shielding for the crew, which from a safety perspective, human factors perspective, was something that nobody could disagree with. You need 3D printing to be involved because the entire principle of the deployment mechanism for the habitats that have been proposed and that will be proposed for the Moon and Mars need to be completely autonomous, meaning they need to operate entirely on their own, robotically, prior to any human arrival or any crew being a part of that process. So you want to have a fully functional system that deploys, builds, and closes the habitat before people even arrive. So on a typical day as an astronaut in X House, you would start out in one of your crew quarters. So there are four that are provided. One would be for you and three would be for your crewmates. Within your bunk, you have a bed, desk, a window looking out into a hydroponic garden. So we're trying to make this as comfortable and Earth-like as possible. The second floor incorporates a shower toilet, so that's the hygiene module, as well as the environmental control and life support systems for the habitat. Basically all of the technical volumes and the hardware that's enabling you to breathe, go to the bathroom, manage the water, etc. After that, you'll probably want to get something to eat. So the kitchen and the wardroom is at the top floor, fifth floor of the habitat. We've introduced a communication station, kitchen, and a communal dining area for the astronauts, and they can, of course, look out to the Martian vista as they're enjoying their meal. Ultimately, the crew is going to have to get to work at some point during the day. So to travel down through the habitat, we have a staircase that wraps around this inner core that we've created. They would descend downwards to the ground level, the first floor, which introduces two different laboratory spaces. One laboratory is intended for engineering, repair, and maintenance of the habitat and other tools that they might need to create over time. And the other lab is devoted to physical and life sciences, so analyzing geologic samples and anything that they might encounter in their expeditions outside. But one of the things that we really try and celebrate is designing for human needs, so human-centric design. and not just running through the run-of-the-mill kind of systems engineering processes that you might find in a traditional aerospace workflow. So that is really the value that we bring as designers and what we do as designers and architects.